just the height.
Looking for a bite to eat. As my tummy starts to rumble, I know exactly what it needs. I hear a pizza calling.
I'm in Scotland again, and I'm up with Chris Grant, and this is our regular Easter break. So I've been up here for 10 days. And obviously, because Chris is a blacksmith, I've got a great opportunity to get things made that I wanted. And I wanted a metal tripod built. So I was trying to come up with the design I wanted and the functionality I wanted in it and how I could best get this tripod to be as versatile for me as possible. You know, they're heavy to carry, they're quite bulky to carry, really for fixed camps, to be honest with you, but I wanted to be able more than one function. So we went out, and from a local scrap place I bought three metal rods. Okay, just, I don't know, maybe 8mm round, just straight metal rods. And then we were trying to come up with various designs of how to join them at the top to make the tripod. And what we've come up with is a really simple, lightweight idea. And it's really versatile, really adaptable to many materials, many environments. And my tripod is built using this S-hook. That's it, this is the tripod. Three bars, or sticks, or poles, whatever you're using, and an S-hook. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna change the camera and show you how we set it up. So to rig my tripod, I have the S-hook and it goes over the two bars. These two bars obviously are the first two points of the tripod. The third bar goes on top of the S-hook and between the other two bars. And then you simply lay it back. There's a tripod. It's sturdy, it's strong. We've been testing it with hanging weights and stuff off it. But trust me, that is rigid. Now, to show you how the tripod will work, I'm just gonna change this camera a little bit more. So I've got a piece of chain here, okay, and I've got Chris to put me a hook, fix a hook onto the third ring down on the chain. And when you come to suspend any pots on your fire, it goes on the back leg, okay, this leg that's not on the actual S hook. Okay, this leg is what locks everything in place. So you hang your chain on this leg, and then hook your kettle on, or whatever you're using, and then hook it up in just the height. So there's my tripod set up. Now, by having this adjustable chain, it makes it really versatile. This chain hasn't got to be a chain. This could be a piece of paracord, it could be a piece of cable, it could be a natural cordage, it could be a piece of withy, whatever. It doesn't need to be a fixed chain like that. You could literally hang a fork stick over the top here, coming down with another stick at the bottom or a notch in the bottom, and that'll be a hanging system. But the secret is, you hang it on the loading or the locking stick. Oh, by the way, this kettle is full of water. Okay, it's about, I don't know what it is in there. 3-4 litres in there. Okay, just look. All right, so it's, there is some weight in that. Now let's say we go out and I'm not gonna take the 3 metal poles with me. Actually, what we'll do, I'm just gonna move this tripod out of the way. Leave it in the background here. So let's go out into the woods, and all I'm taking with me is my little S-hook. Now in this garden we've got lots of different sticks we can use and twigs we can use. So how about 3 bamboo canes? Okay, so we do exactly the same. Hook on the S hook, put the locking stick through the back, and there's my tripod. Now, bamboo isn't known for its strength, as in when it thin sticks like this, but if I get the chains. We hook it on again, hook the chain onto the locking stick. Make sure these lock out properly. There's my fire on my tripod again. Now both of these tripods I've shown you are using, you know, very thin sticks. And what happens if the area where I'm camping, I can't find thin sticks like this? If I was trying to do this with Hazel, they wouldn't be strong enough to take the weight. So I need to use thicker sticks. Well, let's have a go with thicker sticks and see what we can do. So we're out in the bush. We find 3 sticks. I've got piece of beech, a piece of ash, and a piece of sycamore. Okay, 3 sticks, 3 different trees. And then what I've had to do is just whittle the tops down, okay, so they actually fit the hook. So in the same, we do exactly the same again. So hook one over the top. Hook the other one on. Now the ash fits. Okay, like that. Put the beech with a hole in the middle and spread them out and then lay them down. Let's do this properly. So there's my tripod set up again. Let's just position the camera so you can see it. Like I said before, the chain goes on the locking stick over the top. And then we can adjust it. On this setup, we can adjust the chain to meet our needs. Now I could easily go to my car, I can get myself a piece of paracord to show that same setup, just using the chain for convenience. The chain is heavy to carry, The little S hook is the lightest thing, you know, we've come up with. Now you can see the tripod at the back, the metal one, it's splayed out very, very wide now. And it's very low. That's because I've got a larger S hook on that one for demonstration purposes. And we've made that one so we could use much larger sticks and not have to worry about whittling them down so much. So there's my larger S hook. Basically, all the larger S hook means you need to use larger sticks. And what I found is when I'm using larger sticks, I need to cut the stick slightly. So this has been cut to fit the end of my chain, and then the two notches, if I can position this so you can see, the two notches are staggered. Okay, see, one is higher than the other. So you cut two notches in here, and that's just so the other sticks will fit neatly in there. So we're going to set this one up. No, that's pretty much all done. We're just doing the last one. It's working well. I shouldn't need another one. It should be fine. Okay, well, if she wants to make me one, that'd be cool. Okay, so as before, with this larger hook, the locking stick goes above the hook. We lay our sticks out into the tripod. And we are good to go. Hang your hanging system, whatever you're using, over the locking stick. Cook on your kettle or your Dutch oven or your billy can or whatever it is you're cooking out of, and you're away. So this is my top tip. The S-hook tripod. Available for most retailers, or you can buy them from me for an exclusive price of £9.99. Otherwise, go to your local hardware store, 59p. But seriously, guys, I'm not selling them. But yeah, honestly, these are 59p from your local DIY store, hardware store. You know, it's a small little S hook. How lightweight do you want a tripod to be? You just take that with you. You can set up a hanging system using a paracord, a piece of brake cable, piece of wire. Snare wire will do the job. It doesn't matter. But you don't, I mean, to be honest, hand on my heart, when I used to go out in the woods, I used to use hazel and hazel withies and find it and make a hook and adjustable hook hangers and stuff like that. What's the point? In future, I'm taking an S hook. You know, I bought the steel to make this elaborate hanging system, this tripod with various functions in it. Don't need to anymore. Bit of a shame. I was looking forward to making something out of those poles, but maybe we will. Maybe we'll find something else for them. But seriously, S hooks, that's the way to go. One last thing though. Let's say you go out into the bush and you forget your S hook. You haven't got any cordage. I don't know why that had ever happened. There is something you can do. This tripod is held together by the sticks alone. They're not tied at all. They're not fixed by anything. They're just locked in. Here's my kettle. Exactly the same thing. So I could be doing myself out of a sale here, but maybe you don't need a 59 PS hook. Maybe you can use nature itself and not need any fancy wires or paracords or natural cordage or withies or anything. You can just lock it up. So I'll give you a close up on how this works. So the first thing I'll do is remove the chain. And look, give you a close up of these sticks, look. Now the secret is this stick. This stick here has three stems coming off it. The other two sticks have got Y pieces. And that because of this back stick, which is what I call the locking stick, that's what holds everything together. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope you've learnt something. You know, for me it's always about experimenting and trying new ideas and seeing how things can be developed. And I can't say I've ever seen anybody use these before. It seems to work for me. As I said before, you know, in all honesty, I'm going to be carrying these now in my pack. I mean, this will fit anywhere. You haven't got to worry about, oh, it's bulky, it's heavy, it's in the way, or put this anywhere, doesn't matter, does it? No, put it in your pocket if you have to. Oh, I'm gonna get me some of that. Oh, I'm gonna get me some. Oh, I'm gonna get me some of that. Oh, I'm gonna get me some. Oh, I'm gonna get me some of that. Oh,